Karma here, and I wanted to quickly share my Ancestry.com story with you guys. So last month, I submitted my DNA through Ancestry.com to figure out what I am, where I come from, blah, blah, blah. I am aware that Ancestry and any other DNA place takes just a small portion of your DNA, and they try and compare to other people to get their estimates. So far, this is what I've gotten, and also there's a story attached with my results, so stay tuned if you want to find out more. So while I'm reading my results, I am going to be looking down because I have my laptop in my lap, so please forgive me if I do that. So let's get started. So I basically found out that I was pretty much 89% African and 10% European and 1% Native American. So that's pretty much the bulk of everything. Me going one by one through everything is kind of like, eh. The largest part of me is 39%. It's Benin, Togo. I have 32% of the Cameroon, Congo, 12% Mali, 5% Ivory Coast, Ghana, 5% Germanic Europe, 2% England, Wales, and Northern Europe, 1% Norway, 1% Nigerian, 1% Ireland and Scotland, 1% Sardinia, I think that's how you pronounce it, and then 1% Native American, Andean. So that's pretty much my ancestry. There you have it. So when I did Ancestry.com, I submitted my DNA, and what it does is it'll match your DNA with other people, and it'll say if this is a first cousin, second cousin, third cousin, fourth cousin, a millionth cousin, whatever the case may be. So when I did my DNA, I submitted it, and I was connected to a first and second cousin. And I'm like, you know, I don't know who this person is, but that we're closely related. Well, growing up, my father never knew his biological father, which would be my grandpa. My dad kind of just never met him. It was kind of like he knew his name and he knew little things about him, but he never met him. So to this day, I had never met my biological grandfather on my dad's side. So this cousin, well, a few years back, I sat with my grandmother and I asked her, you know, can you give me some details about my grandfather? And she gave me his last name. But I kind of didn't ask for his name. She just gave me a last name because I took my grandmother's maiden name. We never took our grandfather's last name. So basically, it was my grandfather's niece that was my second cousin. So I wrote her on Ancestry.com and I said, I think I'm related to you. I think your uncle is my grandfather. Do you know this guy by this name? She said, yes, he is my uncle. This is crazy. So we immediately swapped numbers and we talked. She then sent me pictures of him and of my biological grandfather. And then she gave my number out to his son, which would be my uncle. And immediately I was like, oh my gosh, this is so cool. I have an uncle that I never met and I never knew existed. So when I talked, you know, my uncle called me and he said, oh my gosh, I'm so excited. I never knew I had a brother. Me and my siblings are all close. My father never told us that we had this other sibling and so forth. My grandfather passed away in 96, I believe. So I will never get to meet him and I never got to meet him. But meeting my uncle or talking to my uncle was awesome. They live in a different state now, but his sister lives here. So I did meet my aunt and we did go out for dinner. I'll probably attach a picture at the end of this video of that meeting. So I did call my dad and I said, Dad, I found your brother. And he was like, what? And I was like, yeah, you have a brother. And I mean, my dad never knew his biological father. And of course, chances are the man probably had other children. So I wasn't as shocked to figure out that I had, you know, uncles and aunts and stuff. But my dad was just like, oh, wow, let's exchange numbers. And so my dad actually got to meet his brother and talk to his brother on the phone. But it's crazy because I'm the only one of my father's kids that actually put DNA in Ancestry.com. And boom, this whole new world opened for my dad and for his siblings. So I did talk to my uncles. I did meet my aunt for dinner, and it was so awesome. Like, I have this extended family that I had no idea existed. And also the simple fact that you could be walking past someone and that could be your cousin. You know, one of my uncles sent me a picture of his daughter. And I was like, man, if I would have walked past her on the street, I would have no clue that that was my cousin. You know, no clue at all. So Ancestry.com did really did help me find that missing link in my family tree, because I also have a family tree on Ancestry.com. So it really helped me find that missing link as to where I came from. And I have a whole new family now. I'm super excited. They have family reunions. And it's awesome. It's awesome. And I try and keep in contact with them. We added each other on Facebook. It's an amazing thing. So I really want to give thanks to Ancestry.com, because, you know, not all stories are positive. Not all stories. Some are more extreme. Some figure out that their parent isn't their parent, and or their sibling isn't their sibling, or they have two different fathers, or they expect that their percentages are going to be different. Me, I'm black. I'm aware that I'm black. I figured that I would have some kind of European in me, which I do. So there you have it. But I was surprised that I was 89% African, only because I really was hoping that I was more African. But unfortunately, I'm not. But I was really like, man, I wish I was like 99.9% African. But hey, you know, I'll take the 89% any day of the week. But yeah, that's my ancestry story. If you guys have any questions, please do let me know how it works. It took me about 3 weeks to get my results back. And you know, I didn't really care much for the DNA percentages as much as I cared for finding this other family that I now have. So now I have an even larger family, and I haven't met my uncles yet because they live in a different state. But I'm super excited to meet them and meet their children, which would be, in a sense, my cousins. Yeah, so that's my story. That's my ancestry story. I'll see you guys later. Bye.